All right, FightHype.com, Sean Patel here with quite possibly the best amateur in all of United States amateur boxing, and maybe, you know, we'll see in 2021, maybe all of boxing, Raheem Gonzalez.
What's up, y'all?
Raheem, how you doing, brother?
I'm feeling good, man. Just finished sparring the champ, Sean Porter. He fights August 22nd, so I've been sparring him for the last 2 weeks, so he made me his main sparring partner, so it's such an honor, and I'm blessed to be in this camp, you know, to help him get ready for August 22nd. I think it's for the WBC silver, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm just blessed to be here. It's helping me get ready because I just got the call from USA Boxing that we're going to Germany and France to have a multi-nation camp and the fight out there in Germany and France. So just ready, just prepared and focused.
Raheem, you've worked with so many champions out here in Las Vegas and across the world. What's your assessment of Sean Porter and what makes him one of the top guys in boxing?
You know what? A lot of fighters, when it gets to like towards fight week, they usually get weak. You know, they tone it down a little bit. Sean gets stronger. You know, it's next week he's fighting and he just looks so strong. He's getting stronger and stronger. So, and his conditioning gets better and better. So, it's just wow. If this is what it takes to be a world champion, damn. So, I'm just learning from the best, you know. So,
how strong is Sean inside? It seems like he has a unique way of knowing how to split the guard once he gets real close in. What's it like, you know, dealing with Sean on the inside?
You know, from the outside, it doesn't look like he hits hard, but when you're in there and when you're fighting in the inside with body shots and stuff, that's when you start feeling it. It's just the later rounds it goes, he gets strong and strong. Usually fighters come out strong like the first few rounds. It seems like he just gets stronger and stronger when the rounds gets going, and he breaks you down even more and more and more. So it doesn't look like it's that hard, but when you're in there, it's a whole nother level. You know,
right.
There's levels to this fighting game, you know?
Right. And yeah, because, you know, talking about how you said it's not quite as hard as it looks on the outside as it is on the inside. His dad was talking about, I need some knuckles on that body.
Yeah, what he does so interesting.
Like he digs,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, he digs. Mm-hmm. And when he punches, he just doesn't throw just to throw. There's an accuracy he likes to do. He'll hit you right here to the in the middle. He'll hit you on the side.
The solar plexus. Yeah.
I mean, he'll just hit you all over until that body breaks you down. He just doesn't just throw a body shot. He know there's so many different ways that you can throw a body shot. I never knew that until I got in with him. It's just usually fights just go. This is a regular body shot where you just throw it like this. He does. He turns his punches like it's a mm-hmm. regular combination. You know, mm-hmm. So it's. I mean, like I said, I thought I was on the right page, but going with him, man. There's so much more I can learn, so I'm just honored to be in this camp, like I said, you know. And Sean now I see why he's a world champion. I don't know what welterweight has a better resume than he does right now. Mm-hmm. I mean, he fought Errol Spence, he fought Sean Porter,
Kell Brook,
yeah, he is Sean Porter. He fought Errol Spence,
Keith Thurman,
who else?
Broner, Berto,
Danny Garcia,
Ugas.
Andre Berto, you know, world champion. So much, I mean, he fought so many welterweights. I mean, which welterweight right now in the game that fought better opponents than Sean Porter?
He's on top. Manny Pacquiao. But
oh, yeah, of course, Manny Pacquiao.
That don't count, kind of.
Yeah, he's a legend. Yeah. But I'm talking about right now in the game, you know, so. Him and Crawford and Spencer, I feel like they're the best welterweights right now.
You feel like he could knock those guys
Garcia.
Off still?
Yeah, for it. Yeah, of course. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you got to get down. You got to get through on August 22nd.
Formella.
Yeah, so. We just gonna take care of him first, and then we're gonna see what's after that for Sean Porter. So,
yeah, you know, being that even though you haven't fought professionally yet, you think there's a good chance that Sean was actually sparring a better fighter in you than Sebastian Formella, even though Formella's got the 22 pro fights. And
I mean, shoot, I mean, you got the best. I mean, how many sparring partners is it gonna be a U.S. Olympian?
Right.
You know what I mean? So I'll be official Olympian once I get my berth in the qualifiers next year. But as of right now, I'm the best in America right now, and I'm much heavier than him. So. I know Sebastian ain't gonna be hitting as hard as I do, so you know I feel like Sean's ready and looking in the best shape as he ever been. So,
Raheem, with you, man, has it been hard when the Olympics got delayed?
Oh yeah,
you were favored to medal, so.
Man, it's been so hard. You know, it's another year of this. You know, it's like I said, with the difference between pro boxing, amateur boxing, you just keep going. You can never rest because, like I said. After I get out of this camp, I got to slowly get ready, get back in fight shape, and get ready to go to Germany and France. And then from there, we got another camp in November. Then in January, I think we're going to fight in Bulgaria. And then March, we got the American qualifiers. Then we got the Olympics. So it just seems like an amateur boxer just keeps going. You never have time to just rest in pro. You have a 10-week camp, and then you can get like a month off, slowly get back to it, and then fight again, you know, every 3-4 months, you know. But amateur boxing, very hard. You know, I'm 24, going to be 25 next year. But I feel like I got the experience, and I'm much more mature to handle this responsibility, to just stay focused, to stay away from distractions, and just keep my eye on the goal.
And if you win the gold medal, you don't have to take as long to build up in the pros, right?
No.
So you could kind of get on the fast track, right?
I'm happy that I'm doing this because, you know, I get to fight every style in the world, you know. And when I turn professional, like my first pro fight, I could go at least an 8-10 round fight. I mean, what do I need for a 4-round, 6-round fight? I mean, I feel like I could fight a top contender,
right?
Not just one of those fighters that's just, oh, he ain't got no name. Like, I'm, like I said, I've been sparring pros throughout the last 4 or 5 years, so I feel like I got the experience. I've been in with the best. You know, I feel like this year is helping me just get more mature. So, you know, and just keep building, keep learning, and, you know, I just want to thank everybody for supporting. And I know I got America on my back right now. So.
Yes, you do. Even recently, though, it seems like some of these guys have come out of Europe. They come in their late 20s, lots of amateur fights, and they just jump right into the top 10 and get into the title fight. And you think that's kind of how could go down?
I mean, I already got 219 fights, so by the time I'm done with the Olympics, I'll be at least 230, 240.
Right.
So I feel like I'm ready, you know? I feel like let me first get my medal. I want to get that gold medal. And then after that, we'll see from there, you know? But I just staying focused, you know? This year is very difficult. Like I said, everyone's going through this. I'm just not the only fighter that's going through this. So.
And also, Raheem, it seemed like when you came out, you got those fast hands and you're moving, and it was, you know, it was almost like the way you score in the amateurs. But it seemed like as the sparring was going on, you said, like, let me set my feet in now and let me dig in and fight. Professional.
Let me just help Sean. You know, if I just hit and move the whole time, I mean, he's getting ready for a 12-round fight. So I know that in a 12-round fight, you just can't do this all 12 rounds. So let me mix it up, you know, help Sean get ready for this fight, not just, you know, just keep hitting and moving. Let me show Sean that, you know, I could sit, I could box, I could sit in the pocket. I'm still a good fighter like you, Sean. So
how great is that for you though to because, well, actually more than that, does that show you got the heart in that once that you can stand in there, not just try to, you know, of course, hitting and moving, boxing isn't so intelligent, but it was like you were able to stand in there in that grown man's game.
Mm-hmm.
Does that not only show the skill, but like the heart, that you get what I mean, that there's going to be times in the professionals where
you got to get into that place.
Right.
You know, you're always going to get tested, you know, in a fight that, okay, I got to go to that place.
Well, some guys feel that body shot for Sean, they stay on the bike.
They stay on the bike. I want to show Sean, like, shoot, I feel it, but I'm right there, you know, because when I'm home, I sleep on the couch, you know, and when I go to a training camp, get ready for a fight, I sleep on the floor so my body could remain uncomfortable, you know. So if my body, if I keep taking those punches and living uncomfortable in a fight, when it comes to a fight, my life and my mentality is always uncomfortable. So when it comes to fight time, I'm ready to go to war. You know, that's the lifestyle we live on, uncomfortable. So we remain uncomfortable. Like when I get back home, sleep on the couch, you know. Then as soon as I get to Colorado, we sleep on the floor for the next like 8 weeks.
Crazy.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't be where I'm at today if it wasn't for that.
Right.
You know, and you know, I just got inspired by this fight. It was Saturday on DAZN.
Uh-huh.
What, Natasha Jonas, did you watch her fight?
Was it Terry Harper?
Yeah, Terry Harper.
I was out.
She's a very good friend of mine, Natasha Jonas.
Mm-hmm.
And I was talking to her before the fight, and she just was so focused, you know, and that got me so focused to be like her in the ring, you know, because she got headbutted in like the second round or third round, I believe, and she fought through it, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what it takes to be a champion. So shout out to Natasha Jonas. I feel like she won the WBC. She should be the new champion of the world, but you know, it was a draw, but you know how it goes in this fight game. But you know, I feel like just to become a world champion, you just gotta have the heart, you gotta have the determination, and you gotta have the desire to win, you know.
Ridiculously fast hands don't hurt either.
Yeah, I don't think like that. You know, I feel like I got more things to work on. I feel like I got a couple more months, a year to go to the Olympics. I feel like I can get fast. I feel like I can get my feet movement could be a little bit more faster, because when I fight at light heavyweight, I'm the little guy. So
I
walk around 169, 170, 171. Those guys walk around 200, 195. So I'm the little guy when I go into that ring. So I gotta have the fast hands, the fast movement. pretty much like a little Tevin Farmer, Sweet Pea Whitaker in there, you know?
Right, so, right. But thanks so much, Raheem, man. Appreciate you. I know you're heading out to Germany and also probably France,
France
right?
France. We got two tournaments in October, so got a lot of work to do. So shout out to USA Boxing. Shout out to this Fight Hype, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Fight Hype, baby. I always be watching that Fight Hype. And shout out to my grandma, grandpa, Malik Scott. And yeah, let's keep going. And next year, I'm going to bring that gold back to America.
Right.
Shout out to my mother. You know, my mother's always there. She lives in California, but she's always giving me inspiration and a motivation to get in that ring and just keep going, because she wakes up at 4:30 in the morning, don't get off till work till 5:30 at night. And then sometimes she goes to the gym after that, so that's my motivation. Shout out to my father. He's always making me breakfast in the morning. He's always taking me to the gym. He's always telling me the do's and don'ts. You know, I wouldn't be here in the gym right now if it wasn't for him right now, because he pushes me even when I'm tired, you know? And my mother too, and my grandparents. And
thanks,
most importantly, God.